Hey, what's up everyone? This week, we're going to talk about typecasting operators in Swift. And I chose to talk about this topic because in Swift, there are actually four different operators to perform a typecast. And while at first glance, these four operators look very similar, they actually each have their own specific behavior. So let's start writing some code and see in which situation each operator can be useful. As you can see, I'm beginning by defining a variable called mystery. And I chose that name on purpose because the compiler doesn't have any information about the type of the value being stored in the variable mystery. And the reason for that is because the actual value stored in the variable mystery depends on something that will be known only at runtime. At runtime, I'm going to draw a random Boolean. And if the Boolean is equal to true, I will store the string hello world inside the variable mystery. And if the Boolean is equal to false, I will store the integer 32 inside that same variable mystery. And so as you can imagine, the only way we're going to be able to interact with the value stored inside the variable mystery in our code is by trying to typecast the variable mystery and trying to typecast it either as a string or as an int. And so I'm going to use a first typecasting operator, the operator as question mark. So here's how this operator works. We use this operator with a variable and with a type, and the operator is going to attempt and cast the value stored inside the variable as an instance of the type. If this operation succeeds, meaning if the value stored inside the variable was indeed an instance of the type we specified, then we'll be able to store that value in a variable that is of the specified type. Then we'll be able to store that value in a variable that is statically typed with the type we have specified. So here, for instance, the variable it's a string is of type string. And of course, as the question mark suggests, in the case where the value stored inside the variable was not an instance of the specified type, then the operator as question mark will simply return nil. So what's going to happen here when I run my code is that if the value stored inside the variable mystery is a string, then that typecasting will be successful and that code will be run. And on the other hand, if the value stored in the variable mystery was an int, then this typecasting here is going to succeed and this code will be executed. So let's run the code just to make sure it indeed works as expected. As we can see in the console, that time the variable mystery held a string, and so that code was executed, and inside the body of this if statement, we were able to use the variable it's a string, which, remember, is statically typed as a string. And of course, if we execute the code again and that time the variable mystery holds an int, then this time will be executed, so we have the corresponding output in the console, and this time the variable it's an int is indeed statically typed as an int inside the body of the if-let statement. So what's important to understand here is that the operator ask question mark implements a runtime cast, meaning that at runtime is going to attempt to cast the value contained inside the variable as an instance of some type. If that cast succeeds, then the operator will return the value typed with the type we have specified. Otherwise, it will return nil. And that's why we often see that operator used with an if-let statement. But it's of course totally possible to use the operator as question mark without an if-let statement. And the common use case for this is when we want to interact with the app delegate of our app. Usually, it results in that kind of code where we get the delegate stored in the shared instance of UI application. But of course, the delegate is of type UI application delegate, and so we need to cast it to the type of our own app delegate class. We do it with the ask question mark operator. And of course, since this operator returns an optional, if we want to call a method on it, for instance, we need to use optional chaining, as you can see right here. Now let's move on to a second typecasting operator, which is actually very similar to the operator as question mark because it's the operator as exclamation mark. This second operator is actually quite similar to the first one, but with one key difference, which is that the operator as exclamation mark will always return a non-optional value. So here it will always return a value of type string. But of course, there is a trap, and that trap is that if the typecasting fails, meaning if the value stored inside mystery is not an instance of a string, then the operator will crash your app. So using the operator as exclamation mark is actually the same thing than using the operator as question mark and then doing a force unwrap on the value it returned. And of course, when you use this operator, it comes with some risk because, for instance, consider this line of code. Here, there is a 1 in 2 chances that this line of code is going to crash my app. So I'm going to run my code and we're going to see if we've been lucky or not. As you can see, in that instance, we were lucky because there was indeed a string stored inside the variable mystery. But if I run the app a second time, This time, we were not so lucky. So we were in the case where there was an integer stored inside the variable mystery. Of course, an integer cannot be dynamically casted as a string. And so the operator as question mark has crashed my app. Of course, this now begs the question of when does it make sense to use this operator as exclamation mark, given that it is less safe than the operator as question mark. And I would say it still makes sense to use it when you are absolutely sure that the typecast should never fail, and should it fail, then it would be a valid fatal error. And actually, a good example of this is this line of code right here where we are interacting with the app delegate of our app. In that instance, I would argue that it kind of makes sense to take the risk of using the operator as exclamation mark. Because if that typecast fails, it means that the delegate property of the shared UI application instance is not of type app delegate, and this is probably a big problem that would cause a lot of issues in our app, and so it makes sense to treat it as a fatal error and crash the app. As a rule of thumb, always remember that whenever you use an unsafe operator like a force unwrap or the as exclamation mark operator, you're basically telling the compiler that you know more than it does. Here, for instance, we are essentially telling the compiler that we know that the property delegate of the shared instance of your application will always be of type app delegate. Here, I think it makes sense to make that statement to the compiler. On the other hand, here, telling the compiler that we know that mystery is always going to hold a string is definitely wrong and so very risky. And so in that case, we should definitely refrain from making the statement to the compiler that we know that mystery will always hold a string. Now it's time we move on to the third operator, which is the operator is. This third operator actually behaves a bit differently than the two previous ones, because this time we're not going to do a typecasting per se, but instead the operator is going to allow us to test whether the value stored inside a variable is of a given type. So I'm going to run my code, but before I'm going to make sure I comment this line that can basically crash my app every other time. And as you can see right here in the console, the operator is was able to test at runtime whether or not the value stored inside the variable mystery was of type string. And when we think about it, this operator is actually more of a sugar syntax, because it's possible to entirely replicate its behavior just by using the operator as question mark. The code would look like this. We would use the operator as question mark to attempt and cast the value stored inside the variable as an instance of the type, and then we would test whether or not the cast has succeeded. And this would also answer the question of, does the value stored inside the variable is an instance of the specified type? And just to make sure, I'm going to run the code so that we can see that indeed both lines of code yield the same result. And as we can see in the console, it is indeed the case. And now it's time we move on to the fourth and final operator, the operator as with no question mark or exclamation mark. And the interesting thing about this last operator is that it behaves in a totally different way to the three previous ones. The three previous ones were runtime operators, meaning that their effect would take place at runtime. But on the other hand, the operator as is a compile time operator, meaning that it's going to enable us to provide the compiler at compile time with extra information about the type of the values we manipulate in our program. For instance, we can use the operator as to let the compiler know that this literal value right here, so 4.0, should be treated as a float and not as a double as it would be by default. Of course, this use case of the operator as is not the most useful one, because it's possible to achieve the same goal without using the operator and just by statically typing the variable like this. But there are a lot of other situations where the operator as is actually extremely useful. And here's an example of one. Let's imagine that we have a function that takes as an argument an NS string. And let's imagine that we also have a variable that stores a value of type string and not NS string. If I then attempt to call my function and pass as an argument my variable of type string where my function expects an NS string, I get a compiler error that says cannot convert value of type string to expected argument NS string. And the reason behind this error is that even though both types of string and NS string are bridged together, that bridging doesn't happen automatically. In the eyes of the compiler, here the variable a string is of type string, and so is going to treat it by default as an instance of type string, which is different than instance of type NS string. But in situations where we actually need to bridge that variable to the type NS string, we can do it by using the as operator. And so here we are letting the compiler know that it is okay to treat the variable a string as a variable of type NS string, even though its actual type is string. You can notice that the reason of using the operator as is not an optional, it's an actual value of type NS string. And the reason for this is that the operator as is actually going to be executed at compile time. This means that at compile time, the compiler is going to look whether or not it is safe to always treat the value stored inside the variable a string as an NS string. If it is indeed safe, then the compiler is going to compile the code. And if it is unsafe, the compiler will emit a compilation error. And so that's why it won't be possible at runtime for the cast to fail, because it has already been checked in every possible cases at compile time. Another example of a situation where the operator as can be extremely useful is when dealing with a type that takes more than one generic argument. For instance, consider the following function that takes as an argument a result. Result is a generic type that takes two generic arguments, one for the success case and one for the error case. If I try to call this function by passing as argument an hard-coded success case, the compiler will emit an error. And this error says generic parameter error could not be inferred. And the reason for this error is that, of course, the compiler is able to infer what is the type of the generic argument success. Here is the type int. But from that same call side, the compiler has actually no way of inferring what the type of the second generic argument, so error, would be, hence the compilation error. But if, on the other hand, we as a developer know what the type of the second generic argument would be, we can provide that information to the compiler, once again, by using the operator as. And so in that instance, I'm letting the compiler know that the value for the second generic argument is the type myError, which is this enum right here. And finally, I want to show you one last use case for the operator as, which is to use it within the cases of a switch statement. So here I am switching over the variable mystery. And as you can see, in both cases, I am using the operator as. Here in that first case statement, I'm using the operator as to let the compiler know that I'm attempting to bind the value stored inside the variable mystery to a variable that would be of type string. And same thing for the second case statement, except that this time I'm attempting to bind the value stored inside the variable mystery to a variable of type int. What's super interesting to notice here is how this code right here is actually very similar to the code we wrote at the beginning of the video when we were using the operator as question mark. And the reason why it is super interesting is because it shows that just like the operator is was a Struer syntax for the operator as question mark, because we were able to implement the behavior of the operator is just by using the operator as question mark, we have the same pattern happening here. So the operator as question mark is actually a Struer syntax for the operator as, because with the operator as, we are able to implement the same behavior than what we have with the operator as question mark. Which means that even if the operator as were to be the only typecasting operator available in Swift, we would still be able to get the same level of feature that we have today with our four operators, because as we've seen, just by using this one operator, we would be totally able to re-implement the entire behavior of the three others. And that's actually all I wanted to tell you about typecasting operators in Swift. As always, if you have any question, remark, or feedback, please let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching the video, and see you next time.